Smoky gray fur. Now he is in C2, that's his cat condo number here at Animal Control, and he's about a year old. And it looks like he was picked up in Meadowview. I'm not really sure what the rest of that word, what the rest of it is, but some either Meadowview Road or street or apartments, or I'm not really sure. I just know it has something to do with Meadowview, but we'll check on that and make sure we have better information for you next time. But hopefully next week Alex won't be here, that somebody out there that knows Russian blue kitty cats and how sweet and affectionate they are will come on down and adopt this handsome fellow, because he really needs a home and he really needs you folks. So come on down and meet Alex with those big, beautiful green eyes that just pierce your insides, because they're just so wonderful and he's just so handsome. But hurry on down and meet Alex and give this sweet kitty cat a forever home. I know, we're trying. Folks, we have a gorgeous girl here. Look at this sweetheart. This is Blanche, and she is looking right back at you. At least she was. Now she's looking at the cats in the cat room. But this girl, I want people to understand that so many people say that dogs look like pit bulls when they're not. They just misrepresent them. And this girl here is a Staffordshire Terrier. There are tons and tons of different types of terriers. She is not a pit bull. She's a Staffordshire Terrier. So take a good look at her. She is a mix. We don't know what all else she's mixed up with, but we know for sure that the majority of her is Staffordshire Terrier, and she's this, got the gorgeous brindle markings. Beautiful girl, very, very smart. I asked her to sit for a treat, and she did right away. She's a really smart girl, folks. I tell you what, when I was giving her treats, she was just staring straight at me. She would be so easily trained. If there's anything else you want to train this girl to do, she is a wonderful, wonderful dog. She is in B18. She's about a year old, and she was picked up stray from Meadowview Lane. No collar, no ID. She's heartworm negative. She's had her shot. She's been dewormed, and just look at how sweet and calm she is. She is a great dog, would be a wonderful companion to anyone out there, a wonderful addition to your family, and just an all-around great dog, and gorgeous too. So come on down and meet Blanche. She's down here at Animal Control just waiting for you.
Yes, you are. Yes. You just,
and folks, here we have a ray of sunshine. This guy has the nickname Ray. Don't know the age, but definitely looks like still a kitten, black and white, what we like to call the cow kitties when they have these black and white markings. He's hanging out in C18. And as far as his age, I'd say 6 months or less, most definitely. And a very spry little guy. He was picked up as a stray from Bullsboro Drive, no collar, no ID. And he is ready to go, as you can see, about to jump out of our volunteer Suzanne's lap and just take off. So if you're interested in adding a little ray of sunshine to your house, then come on down and meet Ray and adopt this little fella.
Good job.
And folks, we have this beautiful girl here. This is Maxine, and we love her to the max and back. This girl is extra, extra special. She is a pointer, more than likely purebred. Now, she's about 8 years old, but the vet, you know, can definitely verify that for you. She's still got lots of life ahead of her, folks. Don't think that she's an elderly girl that isn't full of energy, because she is. She was over here just begging for more treats and being just silly and fun and sweet. And I am loving her white eyelashes. She even has white eyelashes. And just such a precious girl. Look at how sweet she is. And smart as a whip. We just love this girl. And our volunteer Rachel said she'll even sing for you. She makes these little sounds where it just sounds like she's singing. And she's just such a happy girl. But I know she'd be so much happier if she was in your home and getting lots of love from you, because she's got tons of love to give. As you can see, she doesn't want to even face the camera. She just wants to be where the love is coming from. And probably also where more treats are coming from, because that's what she's more interested in, I'm sure. But she was picked up in Tinney Farms subdivision, scanned, no ID. And she is up for adoption, folks, and she really, really needs to get out of here at Animal Control and be in a home. I'm trying to spin her around a little bit so you can see her pretty face. But she's so smart. She knows where those treats came from, and she's just begging for more. So come on down and meet this gorgeous girl, Maxine, folks. I know that she would make a wonderful addition to your family. She's a very smart girl. Like I said, she's a pointer. She's pointing out where the treats are right now. So come on down and meet this girl. I tell you what, she's going to point straight for your heart, and you're going to love her too. And guys, I cannot believe that this boy is still here, this big hunk of love, Hoss. This guy is just awesome with a capital A. He's such a sweet cat. I mean, just affectionate as he can be. You can see with our volunteer Claudia how Hoss is just loving all this attention, loves to be petted. He's so affectionate. I mean, what a wonderful, wonderful cat he is. And so handsome too, with the gray and white fur that he has. It's kind of medium length as far as the fur, but look at that. Oh my goodness, I just want to snuggle with him. I mean, you know, summer's coming to an end, fall is going to be here, and then winter. And wouldn't you like to just have somebody to snuggle with that'll stay by your side all day long, or in your lap really all day long? Because I know Hoss will. He is definitely an affectionate, snuggly kind of cat. And he's in C36, and remember that, folks, because I don't want him to be there long. We want to get him out of here and in somebody's home. And he's got these beautiful golden eyes. I can feel him purring. You know, he's just purring so loud. His fur is so soft. I mean, he takes very good care of himself. He's a well-groomed man, so we know that he is a southern gentleman for sure. Now, he's about 3 years old, and look, he snuggles. He snuggles. He is a love. So if you love cats and you love to be snuggled with and have a best friend in a cat that wants to be your best friend and wants to snuggle with you, then definitely you have to come meet Hoss, folks. He loves everyone, and he will love you too. So come on down. He was I do want to mention he was a stray from Wagers Mill Road. He is wearing a blue collar with a bell. So somebody out there's gonna be missing him, because he is super, super sweet. And I know his owners are missing him, but because he's not been adopted yet, I mean, his owners haven't come back yet, rather. They haven't come back to reclaim him, then he is up for adoption, and he hasn't been adopted yet, and I'm just really shocked. So come on down and meet Hoss, folks. I know that once you pick up this boy and you love on him and he loves you back and snuggles up against your neck, you are going to want to rush out of here with him and take him home. So come on down and rescue Hoss, because really by rescuing him, folks, you are... And folks, we have Jill. I don't know where Jack is, but Jill is definitely here. She is an American Bulldog, and someone has done a terrible job cropping her ears. And really, American Bulldogs are not supposed to have their ears cropped like that, but somebody tried to make her look all tough. And she is nothing but a sweetheart. I mean, she is so gentle. She's got this gentle spirit about her. She loves people. As you can see, she is absolutely loving hanging out with us. And I love the white and black markings that she has. She's got these freckles all over the white on her nose, on her legs, and just is such a sweetheart. So if you're interested in this girl, she's only about 2 years old. She's in B12, that's her kennel number here at Animal Control. And she was picked up as a stray from Bill Klein Road, no collar, no ID. She's heartworm negative, she's had all of her shots, she's been dewormed, and she is ready to go to her new forever home. So if you're interested in Jill, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control. I tell you what, she is such a very special, special girl. And she's been getting overlooked because she's just so quiet and sweet in her cage that she doesn't get all excited like the other dogs do. She's just very calm and gentle and just waits for someone to look at her. And what a special, special dog that is. So come on down and meet this girl. Do you want to mention real quick that she is very smart too? She knows how to sit, knows some basic commands. And as you can see, she is very, very gentle and sweet and quiet and would just be a wonderful dog to have in your home if you're looking for a dog that's going to be a little bit more laid back and one that will just want to stay right by your side. So come on down and meet Jill. She's down here waiting for you to give her her new forever home. And folks, this handsome fella is Timber, and he's been on the show before, and for some reason he's being overlooked, and I don't know why, because he is another one of those male cats that is just extremely affectionate. You just have to get him out of the cage and hold him, and then you'll see what a wonderful cat he is. Just an incredible, affectionate, loving soul in this cat. Now, Timber's in C38, that's his cage number. He's about a year old. And I do want to mention, because I haven't mentioned yet about the show, that there are some pets that are going to be on the euthanasia list for tomorrow afternoon. That'd be Tuesday afternoon. So anybody that catches this show before Tuesday afternoon, please, please, please hurry on down here to Animal Control or call them, ask them who's on the list, find some spots for these pets, because we were kind of, this was kind of thrown at us really quickly, so we didn't know there was going to be a euthanasia done on Tuesday. And the people here at Animal Control, it's just too overcrowded. They've got to get rid of some pets. So I am going to go ahead and tell you that Timber is on that list, but I just want to say that only because I want to make sure that somebody out there that's already been looking at him, thinking about him, or just wants to save a life can have a little bit of time, even if just a day, to hurry on down here and rescue this guy, because it is really crushing our volunteers. We've got some volunteers in tears right now because of this kitty cat. And folks, we love what we do and we want to save these lives, but we really need the community to step up and help us too. It's definitely a community effort. It's not just something that we can do alone. So if you're interested in Timber or even any of the animals down here at Animal Control, the best thing that you can do is don't wait. Come on down, hurry up, save a life, adopt a pet. And Timber here is a wonderful kitty. There's no reason for him to be put down, except he just doesn't have a home. It's not a decision that the Humane Society makes. It's a decision that Cowee County Animal Control makes. And we can do nothing but just make this show happen and get these little voices of the voiceless out there so people know who is at risk. So I do want to say that he is on the list, and if anybody out there can hurry down here and rescue this boy, you will really be saving his life. So hurry on down, folks. This guy really, really needs you, and he needs you now. And we have a guy here that's kind of shy. This is Kudzu. He's going to hide under the bench for a little bit, but he's a very sweet boy. He loves to run around in the yard. He's a lab retriever mix. He's already been neutered, and he's about a year old. Now, Kudzu is hanging out in kennel A1 down here at Animal Control. He is heartworm negative. He's had his shots. He's been dewormed. He was picked up as a stray from Bud Davis Road, and just such a wonderful guy. Now, he's kind of medium-sized, so if you're looking for a dog that's not too big and not too small, then definitely you might want to check out Kudzu. And as you can see, he just likes to hang out right by your feet. So if you're one of those types of people that just likes to spend some time hanging out, especially with football season right around the corner, maybe you want to just hang out and watch a football game, and you're going to have this handsome fella right at your feet the entire time. So no matter who you are a fan of as far as college or the NFL or all that that's coming up, then definitely you want to make sure that you have this guy, like I said, hanging right at your feet, being right by your side the entire time, because this guy is going to, he's like that. He's just a very loyal guy, going to make a loyal companion. So come on down and meet Kudzu. He's down here at Animal Control just waiting for you. And guys, this gorgeous girl has the nickname Hib, and I don't know if it's because they, instead of having Mr. Mr. Pibb. They wanted a Mrs. Pibb because she's definitely a girl. She is, I don't think she's fully grown yet. I think she's probably still a kitten. She's awfully small if she is fully grown. But she is very petite anyway. I was just commenting on how little her legs are. She is marked as a brown tabby, but I see some really pretty rust color in her fur. Really, really pretty. She was just headbutting my hand, by the way, to try to get me to pet her. And oh, I can feel that little motor going. That she is purring like crazy. Now Pib is in C9, that's her cat condo number. And now she's making the air biscuits. She is one happy kitten to be out here with me and Suzanne hanging out for the show. Now, I do want to mention that she's been here since July, and since we are approaching the end of September, there is a chance that she's going to be put down on Tuesday, tomorrow. I know, folks, we try to give you as much of a heads up as we can, but there are just way too many animals here at Animal Control, and so they have kind of thrown a curveball at us here at Animal Control and made a list up for tomorrow afternoon, Tuesday afternoon, to be putting some cats and dogs down. So please, please, I tell people all the time, rush on down and adopt a pet. We really mean it this time. If you happen to catch this show before late Tuesday afternoon, you've got to get down here and find out who's on the list. Try to do what you can to get your friends to come down here and see who's on the list and get these animals out of here, because they really, truly will lose their lives. We're going to do all we can as a rescue group. The other rescue groups are working really hard too, but we've got to get these animals out of here, and Pib is one of those that is in danger. So please, folks, hurry on down and rescue this sweet girl. I mean, how can this precious life be gone tomorrow afternoon? She's got so much love and life and love to give, and just such a wonderful, wonderful cat, or kitten, rather. So please, folks, hurry on down and meet Pib and get her out of here. Get her in a home, and I'll tell you what, she's going to know you saved her, and she's going to give you a lifetime of love and everything she has in return. And folks, we have a very excited boy to be on the show today. This is Jax, and he's super excited because we just gave him some bacon treats, and who doesn't love bacon? So he is super wound up now. But he's a smart boy. He will sit for you, but you know, he can hardly contain himself when the treats are coming, and who can blame him? I love treats myself. Now, this guy is in B1, and he is about 8-9 months old, not quite fully grown yet. Well, he's pretty much fully grown, just not quite a year old yet, but I don't think he's gonna get much bigger. Now, this guy he's this handsome gray and white coloring, so, so nice. This smoky gray is so pretty. Now, he was picked up as a stray from Wilcoxon Street. He is heartworm negative, he's been dewormed, he's had all of his shots, and he is so ready to go home with someone. And what a nice boy he is. Look at that happy tail, just a wagon. So if you're interested in this handsome fella, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and rescue this guy. And I tell you what, this guy right here could be your new best friend. And guys, we have a real handsome fella for you here. He's really nervous. Now he's trying to climb all over Claudia's shoulder like a parrot. There is a lot of commotion going on in the dog kennel, which happens to be very close to where we do this show, and these poor cats have to listen to these dogs barking like mad, and of course makes them very, very nervous, and Chuck is getting a little too nervous. Now this handsome fella has already been neutered, and he is this gorgeous orange and white, and I love the orange tabbies. I have a heart for the orange male tabbies because they have something in their DNA. They are just some of the most affectionate cats you could ever own. And Chuck is affectionate too. He's just a little scared right now because he doesn't want to be fed to the dogs, which we know we're not going to do that, but he doesn't know that yet. Now, Chuck here is in C19. That's his cat condo number. He was picked up as a stray from Glen Cannon Trail. No collar, no ID. And like I said, he is just good to go. He's had his shots. He's been dewormed. And Chuck is just ready to run on out of here and get out of Animal Control and into somebody's home and into somebody's heart. And I know that if you come and meet this boy and hold him and spend some time with him, he is absolutely going to steal your heart for sure. So come on down here and rescue Chuck, because really, truly, every pet here needs you to rescue them, because by adopting any pet here at Animal Control, including little Chuck here, you are absolutely saving their lives. And folks, we're hanging out here with this guy, Parker. Now, Parker is a Gordon Setter. Now, they're saying that he's a mix only because we have to say that at Animal Control. We're not sure if the dogs are purebred, but he certainly looks like he's purebred. I mean, he's got this really nice wavy fur, curly fur, that is very common with Gordon Setters, and he is just so, so handsome, folks. I mean, he definitely was somebody's dog at some point as far as somebody taking really good care of him, and he just got lost. He was picked up as a stray, in the Beverly Park subdivision. So if anybody recognizes this guy, of course we would love to reunite him with his family, but because no one has come to pick him up yet, he has been available for adoption, but really only for a couple days. So we're still hoping that the couple of days that he's been here and been up for adoption, that someone out there is going to recognize him. Maybe there's been some posters in your neighborhood or something like that. But he definitely needs to be reunited with mom or dad. But otherwise, he is up for adoption now. So if you want to come get this handsome fellow, you are welcome to. Either way, we want to get him out of animal control. Now, he's about a year old and black and tan, handsome, handsome fellow, as you can see. So folks, come on down and rescue Parker. He is in the back area here at animal control. So the best way to get your get him is to write down the ID number for him, which starts with an A and then 03 and so on. Jot that number down, because right now they're so overcrowded here at animal control, they had to put him in a kennel in the very, very back that's not on the adoption floor, but he is up for adoption now. Hopefully don't confuse anyone with that. But please, please, either way, you want to make sure that Parker gets out of here and gets a home. So come on down and meet this fabulous, fabulous boy and give this guy a forever home. And folks, here we have little Rosemary, and she's got a big name for being such a small kitty cat, and she is absolutely terrified. I mean, you can see her big eyes just looking at everything, and she's just so scared. But I tell you what, you get her home and you get her feeling safe and secure and give her lots of TLC, and you get to see that wonderful personality just absolutely blossom. Now, she's also that Russian blue kitty cat. Even though she's got little white socks, she would still be considered a Russian blue because of her gorgeous gray, misty gray fur. Now, this girl is about 6 months old, 7 months old, something like that, not quite a year. I think she's gonna stay really small. She's definitely gonna be a very petite kitty cat. Right now, she's hanging out in C11, that's her cat condo number, and she was picked up as a stray, just says Sunrise. No collar, no ID. So if you want to give a kitten another chance and you want to help them to feel safe and secure and give them lots of love and get to see that personality bloom, then you definitely want to come down and rescue Rosemary. So hurry on down, folks. She's been here since June, and it's approaching the end of September, and a lot of these animals are ending up on euthanasia lists because they've simply been here too long and animal control is overcrowded. So I don't know how much longer Rosemary has, but certainly she doesn't need to be here anymore. It's not going to make her feel safe and secure to be in a cage. She needs to be in a home with a loving family that can really give her, like I said, lots of TLC and help her to feel more safe and secure. So come on down and meet this petite little sweetheart, because I know once you meet her, she is going to steal your heart. And folks, this is Julia. She's a very, very excited dog and energetic, ready to be on the show. As you can see, she's kind of settling down a little bit because we filled her up with bacon treats, which these dogs always love. Now, this girl is listed as a terrier, Jack Russell Terrier, possibly even some pit bull terrier in her, but she is still a puppy, so that's why she's so full of energy. Now, she's not going to get a whole lot bigger because she's really close to being a year old. She just hasn't quite hit that birthday yet. But Julia is in B5, that's her kennel number, and this girl was picked up as a stray from Kennan Street. No collar, no ID. She is heartworm negative. She's had her shot. She's been dewormed, and she is good to go. And I absolutely love these markings, the brown with that white stripe that just shoots right down the middle of her nose. She's even got the little flashlight tail, which is the little white flash of color on her tail that we love to see, and we have nicknamed that flashlight tail. So she is absolutely sweet. Like I said, lots of energy. Would be a great dog for a family that's very active, or if you have children. Great with everyone. I mean, she's just an all-around wonderful dog. Very special girl, very sweet, and we love you, Julia. Yes, we do. So if you're interested in this girl, please do hurry on down here to Animal Control and adopt her. And oh, look at her. She's just putting her head right in my lap. She is affectionate, too. So come on down and meet this girl. She is down here at Animal Control just waiting for you. And this little guy has been playing with his little ID card, thanks to Miss Angie here. But hey, we give them anything they want to play with, folks, because these poor kitty cats get so bored in that cage. And Calvin here, oh my goodness, I love this guy. He's purring like crazy. He's got the silkiest little kitten fur in the world, and he is just so handsome and so sweet and so lovable. I mean, we just love this boy. Now, he is, I would say, he's just over... Maybe just barely over 6 to 8 weeks old, And what a lover this little guy is already. I mean, he's just so sweet and so wonderful. Just love, love, love this guy. He's in C33, that's his cat condo number. And he was picked up as a stray from Meadowbrook Lane, no collar, no ID. And he's had his shots, he's been dewormed, and oh my gosh, look at him. He's loving this affection and attention he's getting from Miss Angie. And he's even doing the little air biscuits. He can't do the biscuits in her lap because he's just got his arms stretched out. So he's doing some air biscuits right now. But what a happy, happy kitty, and what a sweet boy he is. Oh my gosh, what a little snuggler, really affectionate, fun, playful, energetic, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, all the stuff that you want to see in a kitten, and a healthy kitten. Healthy kittens are going to be bright-eyed and bushy-tailed. There's something to say, something to be said about that expression. But come on down and meet Calvin, folks. I mean, my goodness, he's just a little kitty in this great big world, and he really needs you. Thank you so much, folks, for watching our show. We just want to make sure that we thank you. And also, please be sure to contact Animal Control, because there is a euthanasia list for this week. We want to make sure that we can get all of those animals homes. And also just want to make sure that you know about a big fundraiser we are doing in partnership with New Link. And we triple dog dare you to participate in it. It is a positively great fundraiser that we're doing. Now, what New Link is doing is any existing customer or new customer who adds service to either their existing service or adds new service, New Link will donate up to $15 to the Noonan Coyote Humane Society. How awesome is that? So like I said, we triple dog dare you for the month of September and the month of October only. If you go ahead and add New Link services, or add more services if you're already with New Link, like I said, they'll give us up to $15 for each of those things. So just please, please help us out with that fundraiser. It'd be an awesome thing. Plus, we want to make sure that we thank New Link, because they do make this show possible. I don't think folks know, New Link, they're the ones that come down here and film it. They send us our wonderful camera woman, Laura, and they make this show possible just as much as NCHS or Coyote County Animal Control makes this show possible. So, you know, definitely want to make sure that I thank Coyote County Animal Control. Make sure I thank New Link for everything they do for us. Thank you so, so much. Thank you to our viewers who are watching this show each and every week and getting the word out there for all these homeless pets in Coyote County that really need you and need rescue. Also, make sure that you go ahead and like our Facebook page. Like the Facebook page for the Help Spay Neuter Clinic, because it is an affiliate of NCHS. And while you're at it, check out our website at nchsrescue.org to find out what we're doing in the community as far as adoptions, events we're going to be at. We're going to be at the Taste of Noonan this year with New Link. We're going to be at the Halloween thing at the end of October with New Link. So we are out in the community even more than ever before, and we need you to come, you know, check out the animals we have for adoption there, and check out what we have on our website. And I think that if we work as hard as we do, and you in the community work as hard as you can, we can truly become a no more homeless pets county. So that's what we all want. We love these animals, and we just hope that you will partner with us and make it possible. So thank you so much for watching. We hope you have a wonderful week, and we'll catch you next time on Adopt a Pet.